Association, this meeting will now come to order. So this September will start our first ever school year. So the government has asked us to watch the nation's children while their parents are off working, so we need to lay down some ground rules. Why don't we start with when we meet every day?
How about 8 a.m.? That'll really piss off the kids.
Okay, not too sure about your motives, but sounds good. Next we should be discussing what we're going to be teaching the kids, so why don't you throw out some ideas?
Math?
Sure.
Science?
All right.
English?
Sounds good.
Gym!
Gym? You want to teach the children gymnasium?
Yeah! Somebody's got to teach those kids how to play around. You know, showers, squats, kickball, teasing, showers, stuff like that.
History.
No, geography.
No. History's more important.
Geography's more important.
No, people need to know when things happen.
Where they happen.
Why don't we just combine the two and call them social studies?
Yeah! I have an idea for a class. It's called detention. It's like kid prison. That'll really piss off the kids. We set up a bunch of arbitrary rules, and when a kid steps out of line, wait! Detention. I piss off the kids.
That all sounds fine to me. Now we should figure out a grading system to use.
And we should send a report card back to their parents. That'll really piss off the kids.
Would you sit down?
Not cute.
Who?
Alexis.
Alexis? I'm really mad at her. Oh, hi, Alexis. Where were you the other night? I only had to watch Friends alone. I guess I know who my real friends are. Oh, really? Okay, call me later. Bye. Oh, Craig, look, it's your dad.
What?
Hi, Mr. Buchanan.
Dad? Dad, what are you doing here? No, you cannot take flash photography. It distracts the players.
He wants a picture.
He just told me I had split ends.
I know, I'm sorry.
Well, you won a victory, well, that makes you a wisher. Cause one thing is for sure, you ain't no Bobby Fischer. Bobby Fischer, where is he? I don't know, I don't know. Bobby Fischer, where is he? I don't know, I don't know. So go ask your mama and make sure you listen. Cause one thing is for sure, Bobby Fischer's missing. Bobby Fischer,
where is he?
I don't know, I don't know. Bobby Fischer, where is he? I don't know, I don't know. He's gone. Hey, who's that smart named Matty P?
It's me. It's me.
I said, who's that smart named Matty P?
It's me. It's me.
Woo!
Are you guys completely insane? This is a chess tournament.
Oh my God, Glenn.
Shut up.
Oh.
I know I'm a dork and I have greasy hair and I've never kissed a girl.
Glenn, it's okay to explore your body.
You two are freaks. Do you know how far you fall in when the chess team makes fun of you? You know, Ariana, once I dreamed of going on a date with you.
Glenn!
Now, I don't even think so. And Craig, I don't know, but I'm pretty sure I could kick your ass. Now, pipe down, you movers. It's only my move.
I was so mad.
We were just trying to be nice.
I know what he needs.
The perfect cheer.
There's gonna be a meltdown, and that'll pretty much end life.
Well, how often do we have to do that?
Oh, I don't know. I'd say 3 or 4 times a day for the next 25 years or so.
What? All right, well, wait. What is work together on this? We'll take turns putting water on the plutonium rods.
No! No! No work! Free movie!
Yeah. I mean, this guy knows how to do it. I'd just be afraid to mess something up, given, you know, there's computers and all, probably a password.
Well, the password is just password 1234.
Make him do it!
Yeah!
have the most experience with this kind of thing. Do you mind taking one for the team, staying on top of that?
Yeah, no, sure, I'll do it. The thing is, it doesn't really seem fair. I mean, if I'm spending all my time up at the reactor, how am I gonna have time to scavenge and farm the land to provide food for my family?
Well, I'm sure we can all agree to pitch in and give you some of our food in return of you saving our lives at the reactor plant.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah. Well, thanks, guys. That's really big of you, but the other thing is, it's not really a one-person job. I'm gonna need a team of people, and, you know, I'll ask my guys, and I'm sure they'll do it, but they're gonna need some food, too.
Well, if any of you guys see him or his team, just be a nice guy and give him some of your food. It's only fair.
Glenn, how are we supposed to know who's on his team and who's not? Anybody could be like, hi, I work with Jerry up at the power plant. Give me some food.
All right. Here's what we'll do. We're gonna make shirts. Yeah, shirts. It's gonna be like, I work the reactor plant. Give me some of you. So if you see anybody wearing that shirt, just
wait. Who's gonna make the shirts?
I don't know who's gonna make the shirts. Rodney, will you make the shirts?
Oh no, sorry. I'm busy that day. I'll be at the movies.
Daryl, will you make the shirts for us? Come on.
Yeah, I guess. But I'm gonna need some food too.
Well, then make yourself a shirt that says, I made this shirt, give me some of your food, and people will give you food.
Glenn, what's stopping someone from making a shirt that says, I did something stupid, feed me for it?
I will be a shirt inspector. Yeah, I'll make sure everybody's shirt is legit. Will you make me a shirt that says, shirt inspector?
That guy sounds like a cop.
No.
Yeah! He's a cop!
Okay, well, my name is Barry, and I used to work at a power plant up by the reactor. Not to be a downer.
Well, Johnny, I wish you hope for a high heel mutual fund.
Oh, you son of a gun, Frank. All right, who wants cake?
Me.
Frank, Gail, are Brandon and Michael coming?
I called them. I just don't know where they went off to.
Is that them over there on top of the tool shed?
Oh, gee whiz. Hey, Brandon, Michael, you mind doing Mommy and Daddy a favor and get off that shed? Come on, guys, get off the shed. It's cake time, come on.
I'll take a small piece and... Hey, guys, your father wasn't kidding. Let's get off the shed.
You know, Johnny, did you think Brandon and Michael's parents were getting you that Lion King video?
Oh, thank you, Mr. and Mrs. J.
No problem, big man. I just hope you like watching as much as Brandon and Michael do. Get off the shed!
You know, we ended up watching that film hundreds of times. We had to buy a new tape. Get off the damn shed!
So, our kid just loves Disney.
Oh yeah, every movie we buy is Disney.
And soon they'll be running the government.
I will shove you back into my womb if you get off that damn shed!
She was just saying,
I will drive you out to the desert and leave you there for the entire month of August if you do not get off the shed!
Frank, sweetie, I was telling a story.
Oh, sorry, dear. Go ahead.
Anyways, she was just saying how hard it was to find good entertainment for kids' parties nowadays.
I will take you to the Philippines and sell your kidneys on the black market! You get off that shit!
Mommy, why are that man and lady yelling?
I don't know, sweetheart. Just don't go near the shed.
Hey, birthday boy. How does it feel to be 9?
Scared.
That's adorable!
I will douse you in gasoline and light you on fire like that Buddha!
2 seconds!
He will do that! And I will videotape it! And play it for you every Christmas night for the rest of your lives!
Now, get off the shit! Get off that shit!
Dad, we're right here.
We're inside playing Nintendo.
Oh, sorry, kids! I don't have my contacts in! All right, let's have some cake now, huh?
Coming in with your associates. Yeah. Now, I know this is hard to hear, but we're gonna have to make some serious decisions about your mother's health. Let's be honest, she is getting on in years.
Oh. Oh, snap. Okay, all right. I see how it is. Your mama is so old, her last name is Asaurus.
Oh! You know, Mr. Lewis, that wasn't an insult. I'm just trying to tell you that your mother's condition is deteriorating because of her age.
Ooh. See, that's a cold one. That's cold. All right, I see how it is. Your mama's so old, in her history class, they just wrote down what they were doing.
Listen, this is not an insult contest, okay? Not only is your mother elderly, but her ability to walk is being affected by her weight.
Okay, it just got real.
No, it's not insulting.
Your mama is so fat, when she goes in the movie theater, she's sitting next to everyone.
Listen, your mother needs to manage her weight or there could be some real problems.
Okay, all right. But your mama is so fat, she's on both sides of the family. Now who's the guy?
I am the doctor! I am! It is my job to make sure that your mother is getting the care that she deserves. We are talking about the woman who took care of you your whole life. The least you can do is take care of her in her old age and take this seriously.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry that I lost my temper.
No, really, doctor. I guess I was just joking around because I know her condition is really serious, and I guess humor is just the only way I can really deal with it. I just know she says over and over again she doesn't want anything invasive done.
Really? Is that so? That's really interesting. You know, she hadn't mentioned that in our most recent conversation. You'd think she would have brought it up at least once during that long night we had together. Snap, Mr. Lewis. Oh, snap. Now let's talk about that procedure.
Mr. Frank Rosenthal, you have been convicted of treason, and it has been decided that you will be put to death by firing squad.
No!
Shut up! Now, do you have any last words?
Yes. Just 3.
Okay, firing squad. Each of you has been given a rifle. And only one of these rifles is there an actual bullet. That is so none of you know who has fired the shot, and do not have to bear the guilt of it on your conscience. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, on my command, you will aim at a criminal and fire.
If you dare.
Shut up. Now, ready. Aim. Fire. Okay, so no one hit him. You still have to aim. Don't assume you don't have the bullet. You still have to aim.
I was aiming.
Well, aim better. Robertson, paying attention?
Hey, why'd you single me out?
No reason.
It's because I have the bullet, isn't it?
I didn't say that.
I'm glad I didn't hit him. I couldn't bear the guilt of that.
Give me the guns back. Give me the guns back. Give me the guns back. Right. Now I'm shuffling the guns. Shuffling the guns, shuffling the guns. That is so we do not know who has the bullet. They're all going to be shuffled. Right. Here's your gun. Here's your gun. And here's your gun.
It was that when I watched it.
Give me the guns back. Give me the guns back. Give me the guns back. What? Now don't look this time. Right.
Shuffling the guns. Shuffling the guns. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle.
You meant free me and tie him to the post, and I shall make thee kings.
Shut up. Right. Here's your gun. Here's your gun. And here's your gun. Now, don't look in there. Give me that. You give me yours. You're this one, and you're this one.
Was it the one?
Nope, you're good.
Oh!
That means I probably have the gun.
Well, no, it means either you or Robertson has the gun.
Well, I'm not gonna aim.
Nice shot.
Thanks.
What?
Thank you all for coming on such short notice. As you know, my granddaughter is staying with us over spring break, and tomorrow is her birthday, so I've decided to throw her a surprise party.
Oh my god!
What a great idea.
Oh my god!
She'll be really surprised.
Oh my god!
Sue, what's wrong?
Sue likes surprise parties.
I really love surprise parties. Freaking excited!
I want to know, does anybody want to help?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Thank you, she's going to be so excited.
Sue?
Sorry, I just didn't know this was happening today. I'm ecstatic to be a part of this.
It is truly nice that you're doing this for her.
I'd do anything for her. She's my peach. Now, do you think I should get balloons?
Yes! Yeah.
I know a party store. I can pick some up over on the way tomorrow.
She's gonna walk in here, and she's not gonna know where anyone is, and there are gonna be balloons, and we'll be hidden. She'll be surprised.
Yeah, Sue. That's how surprise party works.
I know how they work.
That's the idea. I was thinking I'd take her to the park. Tell her we're coming back here for pizza. Now, you should all park far away so she doesn't see the cars and get suspicious. Sue, what are you writing?
All of it. Everything that you're saying. Everything that's happening.
It's nothing. It's just scribbles. In fact, this is the first time I've thrown a surprise party.
Leave Sue alone. Sue, I think it's great that you're excited about this. I am too. I just show it differently.
Oh, I have a friend who owns a bakery. I can swing by tonight and pick up a cake.
I'm sorry, I just feel like I'm gonna pass out. Could someone hand me something to eat? Some solid food, maybe? I just am so freaking excited. Freaking excited.
I know.
Oh boy. My hands are paralyzed.
There's still a lot to go over. So let's talk about the thing we're gonna do next. I was thinking I could do some juggling. From when I was in army class. I still got the nose around here somewhere.
Sue! Get a hold of yourself! Sorry.
Maybe you should go outside and get some air.
No, I'm fine. You know what helped me? A practice surprise. We can all figure out where we're gonna hide.
That's a good idea. I don't want to screw this up, so everybody hide somewhere. Okay, so we come in and I say, "Okay, Annie, we're home." And you say,
"Surprise!
Surprise!
Surprise! Surprise! Oh, we got it, guys! Happy birthday! comes. Oh, God. Oh, God. Here it comes. Here it comes.
Oh, Sue, God. Please, don't.
Grandpa!
Well, to be honest, we were talking about having a surprise party for you tomorrow on your birthday.
Oh, Grandpa, that's sweet of you, but I don't need a party. What I would like is a coach bag for the mall.
Oh, we could all pitch in on that.
The mall?
Anything for you, Cupcake. We could get ice cream.
With sprinkles?
Ice cream? The mall?
All right, everybody, hold the work, hold it down. Where's those other mothers? Get them in here too. Now listen up to Jack Knobs. I found this cherry ring pop, which is delicious, by the way, and this steroid syringe in the showers. This means one of you wing nuts has been juicing. We're not leaving here till we find out who.
It wasn't me, Coach. I would never.
Oh, really, Yamanashi? Really? It wasn't you? You need to do it? I never would have thought it wasn't you. Because of your stubby little legs, pencil neck, low self-esteem. Make me the update, Yamanashi. Nobody thought it was you in the first place. You didn't want so much attention, you wouldn't waste all my time. I'm sick of it. Pack of Joe's, front and center. What's going on here? Is this donuts or are you juicing, son?
Well, my parents are separating, so I'm kind of a stress eating. Mostly cheesy fries and my own hair.
We're gonna see about that. Why don't you fill this up with some of your freshest squeeze, pronto? Oh. For Pete's pepper, somebody there, young Nashi!
You call this lemonade freshly squeezed? Coach, I couldn't make the pee come out.
Son of a mother's lover! Tell it to the nurse, hack job! You're gonna take this cup and fill it up with your pee, or I'm gonna stick a fire hose inside of you. You're gonna have pee coming out of holes you didn't know you had!
I think I'm starting to pee now.
Now, do you guys in this room have any idea what stacking will do to your body? What are you laughing at, Yamanashi? I am sick of it! I'm gonna stick a whole Dixon Ticonderoga factory in your neck! And while I'm at it, I'm gonna take your little girly friend. Oh, that's right, Yamanashi! You don't have one! Let alone the fact that no one has enough decency to hang on to a girl more than a couple weeks these days. You know, back in my day, it took half a bottle of Jackson Daniels to get your arm around her, and if your forearm touched her neck, she was pregnant!
Times change, bro.
Did you just call me bro?
What?
Coach.
What?
Yamanashi! Don't you ever call me bro again. Now listen up, everybody, or I'm cutting your ears off with shears. What are you laughing at, Hanley? I swear this whistle's going up your nose and out your finger, and that's impossible! Now back to my science lesson. You start stacking, here's what's gonna happen. Your face is gonna turn into the hiskadiskadiddle-a-ditta pizza factory. Your back's gonna look like the Andes. The Rockies and the Himalayas are making love. It's gonna get down to your gut. You're gonna start getting the flabsters. It's gonna go down to your cobblers. You don't wanna know what happens then.
Coach, I'm done.
You're clean.
You're clean.
Lay off the asparagus. Now, what's it gonna be, gentlemen? Am I gonna have to test every single one of you? Or is somebody gonna own up? Huh? What do you want, Calamez?
It's me, Coach. I'm the one that's been juicing.
Son of a gun. Yamanashi is suspended.
What? Why me? I would never take steroids!
Because we have to have someone take the fall for Calamez.
Why?
Because, oh, tune in, Toledo! Let's not forget, he's the one who sent us to regionals last year in wrestling after killing that kid in the state finals! Plus, it's his birthday! Jeepers! Now take this cup and fill it up so we can get a sample for Calumet. Get out of here, I'll set you on fire! Let's get back to work.
Oh my god, hi!
Hi, welcome to Girlfriends Talk Show.
I'm here to the max.
And I'm the most Morgan I can be right now.
And we're BFFs.
Yeah, we're such BFFs that we finish each other's
awesome.
Seconds. Totally. Well, we have a great show for you today. We're doing it all on our own.
No, we're not. I invited Trevor Masterson.
You what? He's like the cutest boy in school.
Awesome. Let's bring him out.
Woo! Hey, Kira. Woo! I'm Morgan.
Oh my god, he knows my name.
Yeah, of course I do. I really love your guys' show.
Thank
but
you.
I don't know if I'm like that cute. I mean, I have been working out lately, though.
Yeah. Morgan, why is your mouth wide open? Like,
I guess I'm just so chill with whatever's happening right now.
Trevor's on the school soccer team and the male acapella group called Fortissi Bros. Morgan goes to every show because he's her secret crush.
What? No, he's not. Kira, why would I go to someone's show just because they're like super flame?
Whatever. Why don't you do your song for us, Trevor?
Yeah, sure, I could try. I mean, it might sound a little weird without the other guys here, but. You don't know you're beautiful.
That's nice.
I mean, like I said, it might sound a little weird without the other guys, but thanks.
Okay, first topic. Fashion tights.
Parties.
Parties.
What? When did you guys change the topic?
Yesterday.
How do you guys even know each other so well?
I met Trevor at Tara's party.
Yeah, it was radical. I mean, we played Spin the Bottle, and I kept making it land on Becky Weathers.
Becky Weathers? She's a witch with a B in front. She's always taking unflattering photos of me and sending them to my phone, even though she knows I have very limited texting.
Yeah, Morgan has a Fave Five family plan and only has her mom, me, her dad, Domino's Pizza, and 911.
Wait, why is 911 in your Fave Five?
I don't know. Maybe because I'm allergic to bees? It's not their fault. I'm just always reaching for them.
Awesome.
That's so weird. I love it.
You do?
Yeah.
You know, there's a study somewhere that weird people are the best at romantic bedtime under the sheet fantasy moments.
What are you doing?
I don't know.
Where'd that come from? That's not you.
I don't know what you're talking about. I think I might be entering womanhood right now.
Morgan, you're hilarious.
Really?
Yeah, I feel like I could hang out with you all day and laugh. And then at night, I would go hang out with like Becky Weathers and have like a makeup session or something.
What kind of hell am I in right now?
Awesome. Next topic.
Miniature Christmas villages.
Selfies.
Selfies.
What? Myself isn't so self-absorbed. Plus, my phone doesn't even have a camera.
Oh wait, Trevor, do you remember that selfie we took at Tara's party the other day that we laughed so hard about?
Oh yeah, I remember. She accidentally sent it to her bus driver.
That was so funny.
Oh man, Kira, remember when we went to Panera and I dropped my sandwich and all the ingredients went everywhere?
Yeah.
Remember how hard we laughed at that?
I remember I watched you pick up your sandwich and the people that worked there laughed. It made me sad.
Gosh, Kira, can you just work with me? I'm not like you. You have a boyfriend.
I know, and my boyfriend's older. The other day, he asked me to go sit in the fountain and eat a to-go box of bowl loaded beef nachos. Well, he watched in a nearby restaurant with his opera glasses. When I finished, he drove by and threw a note at me. It said, "Great job. My boyfriend's awesome."
I mean, sounds pretty cool to me.
Trevor, I love you!
What?
Oh my god, what have I done?
Awesome! Join us next time. Later, bye!
Now, girls, have you made yourselves presentable? Well, Mr. Wingley Rye tonight, I wish to present him with two beautiful girls. Surely you want to impress.
Oh, Father, had you really no chance to see him when you went to call on him? Have you no account of him being handsome?
Now, my dearest daughter, as you will recall, this morning Mr. Wingley was unable to meet with me as scheduled. However, one servant was able to come and converse with me, and he revealed that when Mr. Wingley was proposed with our invitation to dinner, he responded with a resounding yes.
Oh, Father, who do you think he'll fancy more? Me with my musical talents, or Jane with her fine complexion?
All I know is that Mr. Wingley is quite amiable a man with a good fortune indeed.
I heard he is heir to no less than £20,000 a year.
You know what I heard? I heard he's an eagle.
Boy! If you do not stop being so liberal with your speech, I will send you straight to your bedchambers without a bite to eat.
Fine. I didn't want to eat dinner with a filthy eagle anyway.
Don't listen to his silly talk, girls. How could I ever do such a thing after having two lovely daughters? When Mr. Wingley rides tonight, surely one of you will catch his eye. Oh my! Here he comes now. It seems as though Portnoy were right. Whatever do you mean?
Mr. Wingley has arrived.
Yes. Thomas, let him in. Capital! Welcome, Mr. Wingley. I am Mr. Bennett. This is my lovely wife, Mrs. Bennett. And our two daughters, Jane and Elizabeth. It must be something of great interest. Considering.
Considering he's a filthy eagle.
Do forgive him. He's a troubled child. Take a seat next to Mr. Wingley.
Fresh glaze.
Look at how disgusting.
Dinner is gone. What shall we do now? Perhaps Mr. Wingley would like to play a game of charades or tour our lovely gardens.
No, no, I'm quite all right.
£20,000.
Well, what an advantageous match it shall be. And dare I say, the advantage is on our side.
£20,000 a year. How delightful.
All right, listen up, y'all. Now, I'm your substitute teacher, Mr. Garvey. I've taught school for 20 years in the inner city, so don't even think about messing with me. Now, I know some of you kids like to play games with the subs, like change the way you pronounce your names, or say that your teachers are y'all used to you bones in class, things like that. Now, I've heard it all, so don't try anything. You feel me? All right, let's take a roll call. Jay Quillen. Is there a Jay Quillen? There's no Jay Quillen here.
Do you mean Jacqueline?
Alright, that's how it's gonna be. Now I wanna play! Well, I got my eye on you, Jay Quillen. Balake. There are Balake? So there's no Balake here today. Yes, ma'am.
My name's Blake.
Are you out of your goddamn mind? Blake! You wanna go to war, Balake? Cause we can go to war. I'm for real. I'm for real. So you better check yourself. D-Nice. Where's D-Nice? One of you says some silly ass name, this whole class is gonna feel my wrath. Now, D-Nice. Yes?
Did you mean Denise?
Son of a bitch! Whoa. You say your name right now!
Denise.
Say it right!
Denise.
Correctly!
Denise.
Say it right!
Denise.
Say it right!
D-Nice.
Thank you! Thank you! I get it! It's better! A-A-Ron! Where are you? Where's A-A-Ron at right now? Well, you better be sick, dead, or mute, A-A-Ron.
Here?
Oh, why didn't you answer me the first time?
Huh?
Well, you know, I said it like 4 different times. I'm just wondering why you didn't answer me the first time I said A-A-Ron.
Because it's pronounced Aaron?
Son of a bitch! You done messed up, A-A-Ron. Now take your stuff down to Dr. Edge's office right now and tell him exactly what you did.
Who?
Dr. Edge!
Assistant Principal Dredge?
Hey, get out of my classroom! Or I'll put my foot up in your ass! Insubordinate! And church! Timothy!
Freezing.
Thank you!
Here's the situation. It's pretty hairy. A bunch of doped up teenagers threw some assault rifles into that ape habitat over there. We gotta get in there and get those guns out.
Yeah. This is a real case of guerrilla warfare. Right, guys?
Seriously? Carl said that as soon as we got here.
Yeah, I did actually already say that. I said that we're gonna have a truck. I was like, oh, this is like guerrilla warfare. Everybody laughed. It was pretty cool.
Oh, my God.
guys. They're really going ape over there.
Really?
Nah, but Bill already said that, man.
Yeah, I said that before we even got out of the truck. The moment this thing came over the APB, they were like, gorillas have guns. I was like, going ape.
Listen, I don't care who said what first. Can we just stay on task, please?
Yo, look at the gorillas in the mist over there.
All right, that was just stupid. Stop it.
Why are they going so bananas?
Stop it!
Actually, I already said that. I said that when we were putting our boots on. Hey, I think Mark heard me over there. Hey, Mark! Mark! Hey! Well, he did hear me. And it was awesome.
Boy, it's pandemonium over there.
There's nothing even going on with the panda cage. Bill!
Someone shot the panda! It's pandemonium!
Hey, I already said that!
No, Bill, don't leave! Alright, listen. No one else can leave.
Man, guys, like, the monkey trouble in here is so high right now.
You know what, Darren? Leave. Alright, we have to stay focused. No more puns, no more silliness, and no more monkey business.
My main nemesis is Bane. And he was basically just a roided out jock with a gas mask. And he straight up broke my back.
It's just... You're cool.
Oh, I get it. You're having an image problem.
No, don't be ridiculous. I mean, I'm Superman.
Exactly. Frickin' white bread! You're boring! Look at you with your stupid little outfit.
My father gave me this outfit.
And your dad's dead. Get over your dead parents already.
Wait, didn't your parents die too?
No, you don't! I was a boy! Now I'm a bat.
Okay, I'm sorry.
My suit is cool. Cause I made it myself. Daddy's boy. You got a stupid S on your chest? In case we can forget who you are.
This is my people's symbol for hope.
Hope starts with an H, stupid.
Well, you're wearing eye makeup.
Screw you! I didn't just inherit my abilities from a different frickin' atmosphere. This air makes me strong. You nerd. With your nerd hair.
Batman, Superman, I saw the bat signal. What's going on?
Commissioner Gordon, Batman and I were just discussing a partnership.
Wait. Why?
That's what I was saying!
I mean, I've been dealing with you two idiots for decades. I can't believe I'm gonna say this, but, I agree with Batman.
Feels good.
Why are you guys being like this?
Someone's gotta tell you, man. You're boring.
Pretty lame.
Even your alter ego. I chose, like, 1970s Hugh Hefner. You chose, like, one of the Newsies.
Whoa. I didn't base my alter ego off a Newsie.
Which Newsie did you base Clark Kent off of? Was it Crutchy?
It wasn't Crutchy.
I'm getting a strong feeling that it was Crutchy.
It wasn't Crutchy, okay? And I'd rather not discuss our secret identities in front of the commissioner.
Easy, Crutchy. I know you're Clark Kent.
Really?
Newsflash, it takes more than glasses and or a hat to change your identity.
Really?
Look at this. Oh, I'm not Commissioner Gordon anymore!
Who are you? Where's Commissioner... Commissioner? Sir, there was another man. Superman, you saw him. There was someone else. He's hiding in the shadow.
You know what? I'm out of here.
You know, maybe all this lameness is why you've never been able to get a date with Lois Lane.
Alright, you leave her out of this.
All I'm saying, what's the point of being the Man of Steel if you don't know how to use that metal? Oh. Enough!
You're adorable.
What are you gonna do, sweetie? Burn us with your magic laser eyes? That'd be a first. You always use it for something stupid, like cutting through an iceberg or heating up an old woman's porridge. Is that soup too cold, madam? I'd use that to take off Bane's arm.
Listen. I came here to team up, not to be berated.
Hey, Clark. Guess what I'm doing under the cape? Use your x-ray vision. I'll save you the trouble. I'm giving you the bird. What's this mean on Krypton? Gratitude?
Ouch. All right, I'm out of here.
What a jerk.
Right? The letter S is also I'm stupid. I'm glad they're dead. Where's your commissioner? You give him to me. Don't you turn your back on the Dark Knight of Krypton. Gotham!
Some trouble unlocking my car, and then I found out I had the wrong set of keys.
Did somebody take your keys?
Would you let me finish the story? Anyways, as it turns out, Jeff Peabody had taken my keys, and I'd taken his. We had a real long laugh.
I thought that's who took them.
Did you ever let me finish just one damn story?
I just assumed that you have Peabody.
I'd just love to finish one damn story.
Your stories are lame, Dad.
You don't talk to me like that.
Do not raise your voice.
You don't talk to me like that.
Shut up.
I am your father.
I cannot believe.
I am a division manager. That is very important. Very important.
People are scared of me!
Why would anybody be scared of you? I hate you, you big fat turd!
I talked with Paula's mother this afternoon.
So?
Seems like Paula's very excited for the sleepover tomorrow night.
Oh, shut up, you drunken witch!
Did you pick up my dry cleaning?
It's not ready till Thursday.
That's funny. But you said it'd be ready today.
It'll be ready Thursday.
You know, I have that big meeting tomorrow.
Well, I'm sorry.
I wish you weren't a liar.
I did not lie, Ted.
I wish you weren't a liar.
I wish you wouldn't call me a
liar. Don't raise your voice at me.
I am not raising my
voice. Do not talk to me like that. I work too hard to deal with this. I'm a division manager in charge of 49 people. I drive a Dodge Stratus!
So, honey, do you want to go to pottery class with me this weekend?
I wish you were dead.
Don't. I think I'm gonna take my car into the shop this weekend.
You mean your lame Dodge Stratus?
You don't talk about my car that way!
Dear Lord!
You don't talk about my car that way!
Shut up.
Drive a Dodge Stratus! You don't talk about my Stratus that way! Listen! I'm a division manager! I can do 100 push-ups in 20 minutes!
I'm going to Rob's house. I hate you. Cold.
Lipton cup of soup.
Alright guys, we're gonna have a lot of fun shooting this commercial, alright? So here's how it works. You two come home from basketball practice and you're hungry.
Alright.
Yeah, sounds good.
Alright, narrator, right? Narrator. And then you bust out the Gino's pizza rolls.
Okay, got it!
and it's your at the end, and we're out.
Okay, and at the top, I'm just kind of doing busy work?
Yeah, just simple mom things.
Okay, great!
Alright, let's do it.
Gino's Pizza Rolls commercial, take one.
And action!
Hey man, great practice!
Yeah, I really worked up an appetite.
Me too! I sure could use a snack.
Gino's Pizza Rolls? They're the best!
Yeah, now they're made with 20% more real cheese!
Awesome!
Plus, they're way better than what she usually makes.
Hey! I am your mother!
Cut! Cut it right there.
I like that, that was good!
Narita, right? Narita. I think that line is supposed to be light, like, you know, hey! I'm your mother.
Oh, geez, my apologies, everyone.
Yeah, no problem.
It's all right, well, let's do it again.
Gino's Pizza Rolls, take two.
And action.
Hey, man, great practice.
Yeah, I really worked up an appetite.
Me too, I sure could use a snack.
Gino's Pizza Rolls, they're the best.
Yeah, and now they're made with 20% more real cheese.
Awesome!
Plus, they're way better than what she usually makes.
Excuse me! I am your mother! Oh!
She really slapped me!
Yeah, I know, I saw that. Narita, what are you doing?
Oh, I was just kind of playing off of his anger, you know?
I wasn't playing angry.
Oh, I guess I just misread it or something. This time I'm good.
Okay, Narita, playful, light.
Just happy.
Exactly.
Gino's Pizza Rolls, take three.
And action.
Hey, man, great practice.
No. Yeah, no. Really worked up an appetite.
No. Me too.
No, I am your mother. I gave birth to you.
What are you doing?
Why are we cutting? I think I know what I'm doing wrong. You don't have to come out here, Nick.
No, Narita, I think I'm going to come out here. That line is supposed to be playful, like light, you know, like, hey, I'm your mother.
Nick, can we just do the scene, man? This should be really easy, but...
He is right. I want to apologize to everyone here. I have a huge feeling this is my fault. So, let's just run it again, and what's that word you use again?
Playful.
All right, playful, right.
Nick, she's not going to get it, man.
Yeah, you should fire her.
No. I want her in this commercial. I heard for that amazing face. Look at that thing. That chin. Like a sculpture.
Nick!
Alright. Yeah, so I say we do this. We skip over some of you guys' lines and give her time to work on hers, and hopefully she'll get it down.
You're kidding, right?
That's an awful idea.
No, it's not.
Nick, I guess there are real directors out there, aren't there?
Yeah, I guess.
Gino's Pizza Rolls takes 4 through 8.
And action!
Hey, man, great practice.
No! I am your mother!
You can't slap someone else's kid!
Is that it? Is that more like what you wanted?
Nick, okay, seriously, man. Can I make a suggestion?
Go right ahead.
Narita, do you have any kids?
Yes, I have 5. They're all actors.
Well, how would you say it to them?
Oh, I'd be like, hey, I'm your mother.
Exactly. Exactly like that. Okay, let's do it again.
Gino's.
Get up here, we don't have time for that. And action.
Hey, do you know who I am?
Yeah.
Do you know who I am? I am your mother. I am your mother. I am not your father. I am your mother.
How was work?
Exhausting. Who knew directing a show could take so much out of you?
I know, right? Yesterday in rehearsal, all I wanted to do was run skits. But all they did was talk about Avatar, The Last Airbender.
Really?
Yeah, they had a debate on which bender is best.
And?
Earthbender, obviously.
Jeez.
Okay, good.
Actually, Oliver and Carter got into it pretty bad. Oh, I broke it up. It's fine. We might be expecting a call from Oliver's mother in the next couple days, but it's nothing to worry about.
What do you mean?
And if you see any unknown medical bills in your mailbox, you should probably just pay them.
What?
And you know that table we had backstage? You should probably run over to Pierroway's later and get another one.
Oh my god.
Preferably oak this time.
Oh.
Kate, I'm kidding. Right? It didn't get out of hand before I broke it up. By any chance, do you know how to get blood out of curtain?
What?
Kidding. I'm sorry you had a bad day. What do you say? I run rehearsal tomorrow. You get the day off.
Really?
Yeah. What are co-directors for? Oh, just in time.
Who's that?
Oh, I invited the cast over.
The whole cast? Why?
Because. The show has to end with a curtain call. Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of Fred 2015.